Hello viewers, welcome to Home Cooking with me, Hema Subramanian. Now that the monsoons are here, I decided to show you a lovely, wholesome and hearty dish. Any idea what that might be? It's a soup. It's sweet corn vegetable soup. Let's get started. The main ingredient for the sweet corn vegetable soup is the creamy sweet corn. So I'm going to show you how to make that from scratch. Now if you have frozen corn or if you have the corn kernels itself, then you can just cook them and then I'll show you how to make the next step. But if you have the corn, the whole corn, just pressure cook it for about 3 to 4 whistles. Cool it, remove the kernels and then we do the next step. In a small mixer jar, take a little bit of the corn and grind it to a paste. Now we're going to make the creamy corn for the soup. So for that, take a little butter in a saucepan. Add the remaining corn kernels. Add a little salt and a little pepper. Next, add water. Corn paste into the saucepan. So this is going to give you a nice, thick, creamy corn. Let it simmer for about 5 to 10 minutes. Take 1 whole teaspoon of corn flour, add a little water and dilute it. Now I'm just going to add the diluted corn flour just to thicken it a little bit. So the creamy corn for the soup is ready. You can see it's thickened beautifully. Turn off the stove and keep it aside. Take a nice white saucepan, add 2 teaspoons of oil, 2 cloves of finely chopped garlic, spring onions. After a minute, add the 1 carrot that's been finely chopped, a few beans, 1/2 cup cabbage. So just mix everything. Just 1 stalk of celery that's been chopped. Add a little salt and some pepper. Add enough water and let the vegetables cook. So now the vegetables are cooked and you have the stock as well. Just add 2 ladles of the creamy corn that you've prepared. Mix it into the soup till you get the required thickness. Now at this point you can check for your seasoning. I'm just going to add a little bit of the spring onion stalks. I'm just going to add the corn flour that's been diluted with water. Now this will instantly thicken the soup. Garnish with some chopped spring onion stalks. So now you don't have to worry about making sweet corn vegetable soup at home. Here is the recipe for you. You can try it and enjoy it. Water into the pot. While the water is getting heated up, just dilute the corn flour with a little cool water. Next, crack open an egg, whisk it nicely. Once the water is heated, just place the Knorr chicken stock cube into the pot. You can see the chicken stock cube dissolves very quickly. Add the green chilies, the soy sauce, the corn flour, the salt. Add pepper according to your taste because some of you might like it a bit spicy. You can see how the soup is bubbling up. It's boiling nicely. Now this is when you need to drop the egg. Gently drop it, and while dropping you need to stir the soup. How quick is that for a soup? I think it's very quick. Less than maybe 5 or maybe less than 5 minutes. Now just garnish it with a few chopped coriander leaves. Recipe is a wholesome, hearty tomato soup. I'm sure many of you love making a nice tomato soup at home. That's what I'm going to show you. Let's take a look at the ingredients. So for the soup, take a pot, add some butter, add 1 bay leaf. Now we will be removing the bay leaf later before serving the soup. This is just to give you a little flavor to your soup. Add the garlic, add chopped onion, 1 onion. To this, add some salt and pepper. Keep it on low flame. I have about 7 large tomatoes that have been blanched and skinned. I'm going to make a puree of this now. Once the onions are transparent, you can see I have a nice puree here, thick puree. Just pour in the soup. Add 1 cup of water. Now check for seasoning, you can add some salt at this point. And I'm going to add a little sugar just to balance the flavors. About 1/2 teaspoon. And let it simmer for about 10 minutes. The soup is done, it's been simmering for about 15 minutes now. You can see it's changed into a lovely, bright, rich red color. Remove the bay leaf before you serve. There you have this delicious, hearty tomato soup. You can make it on a cold day, or you just want to have a nice soup at home, just try to make it and enjoy with your family.